brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span. Sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, none can show him guidance. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah alone, and I bear witness that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is his last messenger. My dear viewers, welcome and welcome back to another live edition of our program, Correct Your Recitation, where we enjoy listening to beautiful recitation of the verses of the Quran, also elaborate on their meaning. Then we open the phone lines for you guys, whoever is interested to recite with us. Today, inshallah, after welcoming our studio guest, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, as usual, and we have our junior participants, Abdullah Muhammad and Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Sheikh Abdul Khaliq and Sheikh Abdul Rahman are going to take turns reciting from ayah number 41 through ayah number 48 of Surah Fussilat, chapter number 41, inshallah. So without any further ado, I'm going to kindly request Sheikh Abdul Khaliq to begin. Inna alladhina kafaru bil-dhikri lamma ja'ahum.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ لَا يَأْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ ولا من خلفه لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من حكيم حميد ولو جعلناه قرآنا أعجميا لقالوا لولا فصلت آياته ما يقال لك إلا ما قد قيل للرسل من قبلك إن ربك لذو مغفرة وذو عقاب أليم ولو جعلناه قرآنا أعجميا لقالوا لولا فصلت آياته لقالوا لولا فصلت آياته أعجمي وعربي قل هو للذين آمنوا هدى وشفاء والذين لا يؤمنون في آذانهم وقر وهو مكان بعيد
ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب فاختلف فيه ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك لقضي بينهم وإنهم لفي شك منه مريب من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها وما ربك بظلام للعبيد إليه يرد علم الساعة وما تخرج من ثمرات من أكمامها وما تحمل من أنثى وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تضع إلا بعلمه ويوم يناديهم أين شركائي قالوا قالوا آذناك ما منا من شهيد وضل عنهم ما كانوا يدعون من قبل وظنوا لهم من محيص
جزاكم الله خيرا ما شاء الله beautiful بارك الله فيكما. So brothers and sisters, we spoke in the previous episode about how the Almighty Allah invited the audience to look into the universal book and the creation around them, not only the revealed book which its verses are explained in details, and that is the name of this chapter. It's called Fussilat, يعني explained in details. Fussilat ayat. But in addition to that, the universal book around us, full of signs, that indicates that the Creator is the only one who's worthy of worship. Then he gave the highest status to those who invite people to believe in the oneness of Allah. And he said, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Then he showed the fate of those يُلْحِدُونَ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا لَا يَخْفَوْنَ عَلَيْنَا. Those who distort, try to manipulate, cast doubts and disbelieve in the verses of Allah, in the ayat which are revealed in the Quran, they are not hidden from us, we're fully aware of them. And in this ayah, the Almighty Allah says in 41, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ. There is a very interesting linguistic fact in this ayah. In the nominative sentence, it consists of subject and predicate. In this ayah, we find a subject. Surely those who disbelieve in al-dhikr. The word al-dhikr means the remembrance of Allah, it means the reminder, it means the glorious Quran. So those who disbelieve in the glorious Quran, in the reminder, in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, similar to إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي آيَاتِنَا, the previous ayah. That is the subject. Those who disbelieve in the Quran, what about them? The predicate is not mentioned. The fate is not mentioned. You know how when Allah the Almighty says, لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَةٌ in Surah Yunus, peace be upon him. So when the reward is concealed, is infinite, is anonymous, the audience are allowed to imagine whatever they want to imagine. And by the end, it is beyond their imagination. So the Messenger of Allah, peace be upon him, says that Allah has prepared for the dwellers of paradise what no eye have ever seen, what no ear have ever heard of, and what have never ever crossed anybody's mind. Okay? So let in this respect, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ, let people compete, let the competitors compete. And on the other flip, when he speaks about the fate of those who disbelieve and reject the ayat of Allah, which is supposed to be a reminder in order for people to take heed and to receive an admonition in case that you are blind, you couldn't see all those signs in the open universal book for a reason or another. Well, Allah the Almighty still said, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا, Allah will not hold anyone accountable and accordingly will not punish anyone without sending a messenger to them, without revealing revelation to them, to guide them. If you haven't received any of that, then on the day of judgment, Allah will test you independently. But He will not cast you in hellfire. But those who receive the dhikr already, the messengers have been sent to them. The revelations came down from the glorious Allah. And then they disbelieved in them. They rejected them knowingly out of pride and out of arrogance. Allah the Almighty did not mention the predicate. He didn't say they are ruined. He didn't say they will be in hellfire. He didn't say they will be on the bottom of hell. None of that. Why? In Arabic, when you eliminate the predicate, this is for a reason. It is to indicate the greatness, the huge volume of the predicate. It's like, you know, I cannot even mention it. I'm not going to talk about it. You know, sometimes when we tell our kids, you know, if you turn on the TV, you will see. You will see what? He didn't say anything. He didn't name a punishment. Will you be grounded? You will be disciplined? Will you smack? He didn't say anything. So the child is kind of warned with a severe warning. It is more severe than if you specify and you say, if you turn on the TV, or if you eat too much candy, or if you do whatever, I'm going to suspend you, or I'm going to ground you, I'm going to take the tab away from you. Okay, I know the end of it. But you will see, I'm warning you. That is the severest warning. So accordingly, in this ayah, the Almighty Allah says, if you examine the ayah grammatically, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ, this whole thing is a subject. Those who disbelieve in the dhikr, in the reminder of Allah, after it has come to them. Yeah. What? What is next? Allah did not mention it in order to let the audience imagine how severe, how huge, how terrible, how frightening will be the torment or the consequences of disbelieving in the reminder after it has come to you. Then he says, and how dare you disbelieve in the dhikr, which is from Allah, وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ, and indeed it is a mighty book. Wait a minute, the word mighty, powerful, perfect, absolute, has no error whatsoever. You can describe a being, not a book, right? But why do you say to the book Aziz? Because the book, the Quran, is actually the word of Allah. So it is a description of Allah. It is His speech. Unlike what the Mu'tazila believe that it is created by Allah. No, the Quran is not created by Allah. Its gloriousness comes from the fact that Allah spoke it. Allah said it. We say, Kalamullah, the speech of Allah. Al-Munazzalu ala abidihi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is the word, the speech of Allah, which He has revealed unto Muhammad, peace be upon him. Al-Muta'abbadu bitilawatihi, which if you recite, this is an act of worship. Al-Mutahadda bi-aqsari suratin min suwarihi, which Allah the Almighty challenged all the Arab and all the non-Arab, and not only the human beings, Arab and non-Arab, but al-jinn wal-ins, human beings and the jinn. قُلْ لَإِنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Even if the jinn and ins happen to have council meetings, and we can see the jinn and they obviously can see us, but now we can see them and say, hey guys, we need to bring something similar to the Quran in order to challenge the Quran, in order to defeat the Quran. So all the human beings and all the jinn, all the intellectual scholars and the thinkers, متحدى بأصغر سورة من سورة من سورة, they will never be able to come up with a surah similar to the shortest. And when it comes to the Quran, Abdullah, we don't say small surah. There is no small. It's all large. It's all big, because it is the word of Allah. But it is okay to say short, because it consists of four verses, three verses. Like, so what is the shortest surah in the Quran? Huh? إِنَّا أَعْطَيْنَاكَ الْكَوْثَرِ فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرِ. How many ayahs? Only three. Okay? But you don't say that's a small surah. You never say a small, describing the word of Allah. It is great. It is magnificent. It is aziz. So when you say aziz, that's understood. That's typical, because it is the word of Allah. So it must have his traits. So when we say hakim, the Quran is hakim, because it comes from hakim. Aziz, because it comes from aziz, from the mighty one, Al-Aziz. And why is it Aziz? Allah the Almighty says, verily, those who disbelieved in the reminder in the Quran, when it came to them, then we said the predicate is not mentioned, and it means, shall receive a terrible torment. And verily, it is an honorable, respected book, because it is the speech of Allah, and He has protected it. Kitab Aziz, mighty. And since it is a mighty book, no one can ever alter it. Unlike the previous books, the books of the Jews, the books of the Christians, the books of David, or any book before that, which was revealed by Allah, we know that in the Quran, Allah has told us, Suhufi Ibrahim, وصحف موسى. And he spoke about الزبور, which was sent to Prophet David. We believe in those books collectively, but we also believe that those books have been altered and have been changed, because the Almighty Allah did not provide them with the divine protection. Why? Because it is expected that there will be following books and following revelations. So Isa alayhi salam said, مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَةِ. Hey guys, I came just to confirm whatever was revealed before me of the Torah. He didn't have a new Sharia. He just came to make things easier for Bani Israel after they've made it difficult for themselves. Then he said, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدٍ. And in order to give you a glad tiding with a messenger whose name will be Ahmad. We spoke about that before. Now, so the glorious Quran, لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه. I want every one of you to memorize this ayah. وإنه لكتاب عزيز. Indeed, it is a mighty book. And we knew what it means. لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من حكيم حميد. What is the meaning of, we all know the word batil, which is the opposite of haq. Batil means falsehood. Falsehood can never come to it from before it or behind it. Because it is a tanzeel, it has been sent down by Allah. Who is He? Al-Hakim, Al-Hamid. The all-wise, the all-worthy of praise. Wait a minute. This ayah is very beautiful, brothers and sisters. I'm not on a hurry. I'm not rushing to finish the whole Quran and a tafsir. I'm more focused and I'm more concerned about comprehending one ayah at a time. Enjoying the meaning of the Quran. Look, when we learn the previous ayah and how the predicate is eliminated for a greater purpose, then mention it. So the Almighty Allah says the Quran is mighty book. And He says, لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه. What is the meaning that the falsehood can never come to it from before it nor from behind it? What does it mean? يعني not a single book was revealed before it would refute it or abrogate it. Neither the Torah nor the Gospel or any book. Rather, it does this to all the previous books. It abrogates whatever was revealed before. ولا من خلفه من بين يديه ولا من خلفه. And until the Day of Judgment, there will not be a single book that would come to refute the Quran or find any draws or any drawbacks or any deficiency or any mistakes or errors in the Quran. Not a book of science, nor a book of language, nor a book of wisdom. It is indeed the perfect word of Allah. Tanzeel has been sent down. By whom? Min Hakimin. Hakim yani all wise. Every word in it is full of wisdom. Hamid, he's all worthy of praise. And why the word Hamid, Allah's beautiful trait, was mentioned in this context? Because the ultimate gift that Allah bestowed upon humanity is sending to them His speech. You know, Allah is all worthy of praise anyway for giving us life, for giving us food, for giving us cure whenever we fall ill, for saving us from calamities, for answering our call. 4444. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you try to count Allah's blessings upon you, never will you be able to keep record. That's understood. But that is the greatest and the ultimate gift that Allah the Almighty bestowed upon humanity. In the jinn, revealing His word, because it's an infinite guidance. All the previous books were kind of temporary and they suffered the alteration, but this book, no. And how do you know? Because the one who said Tanzeel, the one who sent down the book, stated in Surah Al-Hijr in ayah number 9, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. Most certainly, it is Allah who sent down a zikr, the reminder of the Quran. Then most certainly He said, we shall protect it, we shall preserve it. It is no secret, brothers and sisters, how much money is spent in order to alter the Quran. And the evil occupation forces who occupied the Middle East, the Muslim countries, India and Pakistan, used to be all one Indian subcontinent, east of Asia, the whole of Africa, north of Africa, all of that, all those, occupation forces, which they call them colonization, they announce that so long as those guys have this book, we cannot do anything with them. Even if we manage to do some change currently, but the book will rebounce, will make them come back. And this is what is happening. So they try with the Sunnah, but it keeps bouncing back. They try with the Quran, and even they pay some Muslims and tempt them in order to, so that they will be the enemy within. But all the effort is in vain. Any child in the streets of Pakistan, any child in the streets of Bangladesh, India, in Minnesota, in the United States, we have thousands of Huffaz who know the Quran by heart. So even if you guys collect all the Quran in China and say, no more Quran, okay, you've taken all the hard copies, take the soft copies too, because it's in the heart. You want to take the Quran, take our hearts. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقْبِضُ الْعِلْمَ انْتِزَاعًا وَإِنَّمَا يَقْبِضُهُ بِقَبْضِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. On the day of judgment, Allah the Almighty will not take out the Quran and knowledge by making the scholars or those who have memorized the Quran forget it. No, that's not going to happen. Rather, it will take place by taking the souls of those who maintain and preserve the Quran and the knowledge in their hearts. So only those who are potato heads will remain, the ignorant ones. So whenever they are asked, they would not say no, they will give a fatwa, but it would be the wrong fatwa. Last ayah, مَا يُقَالُ لَكَ إِلَّا مَا قَدْ قِيلَ لِلرُّسُلِ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ وَذُو عِقَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, be patient. Nothing is said to you of the offensive words, of the false allegations, of the lies and false accusations against you, except what was said to all the messengers before you. Verily, your Lord is a possessor of forgiveness, and he's a possessor of the painful torment. Here is a point. In Surah Al-Zariyat, chapter number 51, ayah number 52, we find Allah the Almighty says, كَذَلِكَ مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا قَالُوا سَاحِرٌ أَوْ مَجْنُونَ أَتَوَاصَوْا بِهِ بَلْ هُمْ قَوْمٌ طَاغُونَ. That is after he mentioned the story of Prophet Abraham and the opposition of his people. Then the story of Prophet Lut. Then he's spoken about Prophet Salih, Prophet Hud, Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. And finally with Prophet Nuh and how he drowned his people. Then after these short reminders, and many prophets were mentioned in this short verses, Allah the Almighty says, so O Muhammad, you're not alone, you're not unprecedented in this regard. As people belied their prophets, as people accused their prophets and they said some awful and offensive words to them, they will say the same to you. مَا أَتَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا قَالُوا. They've accused all the prophets of being sorcerers or even insane. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to what is best. Brothers and sisters, time is zipping by very fast. I can't believe myself, it's already more than half hour. Let's take a short break and we'll be back inshallah in a couple of minutes for some more. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud. Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. I know we have a short time, less than 15 minutes, but there is plenty of barakah in the time, God willing. So let me remind you with our phone numbers in case that you're interested to recite those ayat. You don't have to recite as good as Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, because I know you can't, nor Sheikh Abdul Rahman, but we can always try. So the phone numbers code 002, then 02385531. Alternatively, area code 002, then 01005469323. Two sub numbers, area code 001347806125. And finally, area code 001361489 1503. Let's begin with our junior reciter here, or learner, Abdullah, our studio guest. Abdullah, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum
salam. Barakallah feek. So go ahead and recite from 41. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الذين كفروا بالذكر لما جاءهم وإنه لكتاب عزيز. لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنذير من حكيم حميد ما يقال لك إلا ما قد قيل للرسل من قبلك إن ربك لذو مغفرة وذو عقاب أليم ولو جعلناه قرآنا أعجميا لقالوا لولا فصلت آياته أعجمي وعربي قل هو للذين آمنوا هدى وشفاء والذين لا يؤمنون في آذانهم وقر وهو عليهم عمى أولئك ينادون من مكان بعيد.
Okay, حسبك يا عبد الله. I just want to explain to the viewers, ما شاء الله, عبد الله and Muhammad are brothers. You can tell. They're even dressed up similar to each other, ما شاء الله. He recited the word A'jami very good, mashallah. In fact, there is a little trick here because it is neither recited like a ha nor as a clear hamza. The two ways of the recitation of this particular word, because this is it's a question, okay? So the first hamza is the hamza of the questioning. And the other one is read normally with tasheel. With tasheel. What does it mean with tasheel? It is kind of skipped. You say, a'jami, a'jami. It's like you're about to say, a'jami, but you did not really pronounce the hamza from its articulation point. A'jami. Some people make it a little extreme and they say a'jami as if they are going to pronounce ha, but that is not correct. It is actually in between. That is called tasheel, to make it easier so you don't. The brothers are doing a magnificent job there, mashallah, mashallah. So the second alif is in a condition of tasheel, it is delivered with ease. It is not pronounced as sharp as the hamza from its articulation point, which is the a. No. Neither the ha from its articulation point, which is the ah. No. Rather, it is in between. So it is read as a'jami wa arabi. Yani. That's strange. A'jami, yani non-Arabic Quran, revealed to an Arabic person. And we'll come to this ayah, inshallah, in the future. And we'll explain it. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have Muhammad from the KSA. Muhammad, assalamu alaikum.
Yes.
Yeah, Muhammad. How are you? Muhammad?
Sorry.
Can you hear me?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Muhammad. Yes. Muhammad, can you start? Inna ladina kafaru bi dhikri lamma ja'ahum. That is ayah number 41.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. إن الذين كفروا بالذكر لما جاءهم وإنه لكتاب عزيز لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من حكيم حميد ما يقال لك إلا ما قد قيل للرسل من قبلك إن ربك لذو مغفرة وذو عقاب أليم ولو جعلناه قرآنا أعجميا لقالوا لولا فصلت آياته أعجمي وعربي قل هو للذين آمنوا هدى وشفاء والذين والذين لا يؤمنون في آذانهم وقر عليهم عمى أولئك ينادون من مكان بعيد ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب فاختلف فيه ولولا كلمة من ربك لقضي بينهم
وإنهم
لفي منهم قريب.
حسبك حسبك محمد حسبك بارك الله فيك جزاك الله خيرا. Thank you for your effort. May Allah bless you and your family. I want parents to encourage their children to participate because this is the greatest thing that you can do for your children at this age. Obviously, not just to learn how to read, but this is just the beginning. Because when a person doesn't know how to read, then there is a huge barrier, a huge wall between the person and even comprehending the Quran, understanding. It feels like, you know, Ajami, that's another language. I have no clue about it. I don't understand it. But when you break that barrier and when you blow it away and you excel in the recitation, as you see, mashallah, we have a lot of youth, a lot of youngsters who know how to read Quran better than many of the adults. What is the reason? Because they have learned since their childhood in what is called madrasa, okay, in the schools. While many adults are kind of reluctant, they have become doctors, they become professors, they become principals, they become pilots, but they're reluctant to open the Quran. Why? Because they think, I don't know how to read. Even when they make it to the masjid and there is a halqa, they never sit in a halqa, even as audience, because they're embarrassed, you know? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Nasser from Oman. Assalamu alaikum, Nasser. Nasser? Okay, no problem. Try again, Nasser from Oman. We'll be happy to take your call, inshallah. All right. So, Muhammad, go ahead and continue. وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ. أكمل.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب فاختلف فيه ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك لقضي بينهم وإنهم لفي شك منه مريب من عمل صالحا فلنفسه ومن أساء فعليها وما ربك بظلام للعبيد إليه يرد علم الساعة وما تخرج من ثمرات من أكمامها وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تضع إلا بعلمه ويوم يناديهم أين شركائي قالوا آذناك ما منا من شهيد.
حسبك يا عبد الله بارك الله فيك. We only have a couple minutes left, so we'd like to hear Muhammad read اقرأ from إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ. Go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِالذِّكْرِ لَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ وَإِنَّهُ لَكِتَابٌ عَزِيزٌ لَا يَأْتِيهِ الْبَاطِلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَلَا مِنْ خَلْفِهِ تنزيل من حكيم حميد ما يقال لك إلا ما قد قيل للرسل من قبلك إن ربك لذو مغفرة وذو عقاب أليم ولو جعلناه قرآنا أعجميا لقالوا لولا فصلت آياته أعجمي وعربي قل هو للذين آمنوا هدى وشفاء والذين لا يؤمنون في آذانهم وقر وهو عليهم عمى أولئك ينادون من مكان بعيد ولقد آتينا موسى الكتاب فاختلف فيه ولولا كلمة سبقت من ربك لقضي بينهم وإنهم لفي شك منه مريب.
حسبك يا محمد. بارك الله فيكم. So in fact, brothers and sisters, we've come to the end of today's edition of Correct Your Citation. And until next week, I leave you all in the care of Allah. I want to thank our studio guests. Thank you so much. May Allah bless you, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, Sheikh Abdul Rahman, Abdullah, and Muhammad. And you too, brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you wherever you are. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. And we were chosen to be part of his nation.